governments have had to restore the financial wealth of our country. In order to do that, the present government has had to make savings, and councils were asked years ago to think differently and to play their part to allow the economy to grow. In Wirral, Labour chose instead to sit there wringing their hands, and they were unable to adapt to any blue sky thinking. And as a council, we owe it to our residents to make sure that every penny that we spend, which we take out of their pockets, is spent efficiently. So shame on Labour, who chose over the years to spend thousands upon thousands of pounds on their pet projects. We've also already mentioned the Wirral View newspaper, the huge salaries for senior officers, and of course the prolific use of consultants. We've challenged you on those issues many times, and we've challenged you on many others. And the then previous leader of this council must have realised at last that his financial management of the council was woeful, and he threw in the towel. And I'm sorry to say, because I really like Pat Hackett, but it appears, Pat, that now you, as the present leader, you've run out of excuses and you have reached the same conclusion. And you too are about to throw in the towel. What a shame, Pat, because what an absolute shame, because I do believe that Pat has worked wonders in bringing this council and the various political groups together far more than we've ever worked together. But Mr. Mayor, Labour don't even get the basics right. We've just heard from Councillor Gray about dog fouling. The idea that was brought to the recent Environmental Committee was that, from Councillor Gray's recommendations, that we would like to put up some signs to tell people not to allow their dogs to foul. What an absolute farce, because there is simply no threat of anything. There's no threat of fines, there's no threat of court action, because over 12 months ago, they sacked the company who was doing the enforcement.
Stark facts of austerity impacts on the lives of many of our residents. The gap between the richest and poorest is getting worse, where the most vulnerable members of our communities are suffering the most. The fact that women have come off worse under this government shows us again and again how divisive the politics of austerity are and continue to be. My residents, your residents, are suffering under this government and still you do nothing. As we look at this year's budget, once again the government has failed to provide enough for adequate social care, failed to provide enough to look after children and young people, failed to provide enough to look after people with disabilities. Since 2010 we've had the bedroom tax, swindling welfare reform, consistent underfunding of the NHS, police, prison and probation services. And we've seen the most deprived councils suffer from massive reductions from central government in funding. And austerity has repeatedly pushed more and more of the cost of this onto local people through council tax. Yet I've built into my budget, our budget, a council tax reduction for 9,000 least well-off households on the road. Even as the government has failed to protect those least well-off, this council has found a way to help them. And we're going much further, Mr. Mayor. It's not just the least well-off in Wirral we're aiming to help, but all those in the middle ground, including local companies and small businesses. We'll be supporting local companies, and through that, workers, to keep wealth generated in Wirral right here for the benefit of our residents. Our community wealth building strategy and our community bank will be able to play a transformative role in people's lives, helping small businesses to grow and succeed. And we will be tackling financial exclusion through our financial inclusion strategy that we put through Cabinet last week. This is ethical economics, Mr. Mayor. It's about protecting local businesses and residents from the ravages of the free market and from the political vandalism that is now a no-deal Brexit. Mr. Mayor, a budget is a statement of values, and these are our values. A council who cares about the most vulnerable, a council who cares about its workforce, a council who is determined to grow and regenerate the borough in the absence of government investments and in the face of government neglect. A council who will support and grow local businesses, social enterprise and will lead community-led regeneration from the grassroots up. A council who values care leavers. A council who invests in communities. So, it's simply untrue to say we have no ambition. We will always work to ensure the best outcomes for our residents. We will still continue to fight for them, despite the continued avalanche of cuts meted out by governments of the rich and the privileged. Wirral deserves better than this, and the party opposite know this. Instead of searching for the next cheap slogan for your campaign leaflets in May, I suggest you start holding your own government to account on behalf of the people you purport to represent. I commend this budget, the hard work of members and officers, and I'm proud to call it a Labour budget. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councilman. Thank you for keeping within the time. Right, okay, we move on now to Councillor Gilchrist. We now have up to 5 minutes to reply to the debate.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. First of all, I want to congratulate Councillor Hayes on his maiden speech. As Councillor Williamson says, there is a lot of cooperation going on in the background, especially on the local plan, Councillor Hayes, and on green issues. The budget actually has substantial elements of collaboration and cooperation, and some people are perhaps a bit quieter about that. Councillor Cleary says that the Conservatives have misread the mood of this council and I think misread the mood of the borough. Councillor Rennie talks about the conversations she's had, I believe what she says. Can we have those conversations with all parties in public and not the rating of a government minister in private? Councillor Tony Jones says it's easier to condemn than to cooperate, and that's unfortunately the case for the debate tonight. Councillor Cox was very keen to highlight the increased grant, but that's the case for 1 year. The other side of the increased grant is the government's expectation that we should put our budget up, our costs to the ratepayers up, ask the council taxpayers to pay more towards adult care, and that's what the budget does. made to the inequalities in Wirral. All right. There's a huge gap between the people living on the deprived parts of Wirral, how long they expect to live, how many years they can have expect to have a healthy life, and those. It's about 10, 11 or 12 years from different parts of Wirral, from one side to the other. And collaboratively, we need to tackle that health inequality. I became a member, and I won't play all the histories, 41 years ago. At that time, Birkenhead had social problems. We had places like Tea Street with hardly anyone working in. We had open urban gardens, a monument to misplaced construction costs, concrete with underfloor heating. We have a chance through this growth company to change the face of Wirral. Wirral is changing. We have the power to change it by working collectively. Unfortunately, the Conservative budget amendment tonight was hardly a budget amendment, hardly an alternative to the budget. Unfortunately, it was misplaced. We can't support it. It's our duty as a body to research, to question, to cooperate, collaborate when necessary, because if we as a council can get the basics right, we believe that Wirral will be a better place, and that's what we should all be aiming for.
Since you're elected, I look forward to doing so in the 3 years ahead. Mr. Mayor, I'd like to pick up on the comments by Councillor Nolan. Councillor Nolan said that the Labour Party is running out of patience. Our position is that if that's the case, what is the Labour Party going to do about it? There's nothing in this policy tonight that says what they're going to do about it, the fact they've run out of patience. It's more hot air as usual. Councillor Gilchrist, in his first remarks, made reference to my dog. Mr. Mayor, I would have thought he, as a Liberal leader, of all people, would know that Liberal leaders and dogs do not mix. The best observation, Mr. Thorpe, at this point. Mr. Mayor, secondly, I'd like to come on to Councillor Tony Jones. Councillor Tony Jones believes it's nasty that the Conservative group are trying to hold his group to their promises. I'm sorry he feels that way, but that is the job of the opposition. You were elected as leaders. We are the opposition. It is our job to hold you to account on promises you made 12 months ago and on promises you made that deliver on basics that Councillor Gilchrist has just outlined. You are failing. Councillor Whittingham is simply wrong, not for the first time, as Councillor Rennie has alluded to. In 2010, the government was spending £673 billion of taxpayers' money. This year, 2020, they are spending £847 billion of taxpayers' money. That is not a reduction in public spending by anybody's account, unless it is accounted for in streetlights. Mr. Mayor, Councillor Leach then said that we on this side have no idea what is happening out there. I'll tell her what is happening out there, Mr. Mayor, in case she hasn't noticed. In December, out there, this country elected the biggest Conservative majority for 32 years. Yep. That is what is happening out there. Her failing rhetoric is calling for death. Well, the world is not an island. You depend on the national government for money, and you haven't elected a government because of the claptrap you've come out with tonight. Mr. Mayor, they wanted Councillor Brian Kenny, and who let the cat out of the bag, really. Councillor Kenny, who we know has been facing deselection problems for a while in Bidston, I'm glad to say he's been reselected, but he's now quoting John McDonnell. It's easy to quote John McDonnell when he's on his way out. You weren't quoting him when he was here running your party, were you, Mr. Mayor? And then we come on to the last point, really, Mr. Mayor. This isn't a budget for the well-being of the borough. It's a pitch for the leadership of the Labour Group. It's a pitch to avoid deselection, as we've heard by similar comments from the members opposite. Mr. Mayor, talking of the Labour leadership, my last point, and it's a financial point, not a personal point, as Councillor Rennie has said, we all like Councillor Pat Hackett. Who could not like Councillor Pat Hackett? But on a financial view alone, the decision by the Labour Party not to hold a by-election in New Brighton on the same day as elections in this borough will cost this hard-pressed Labour Council £15,000 to run a by-election in the summer. That is a political decision. That is a political decision by a cash-strapped Labour Council. You can find the money when it suits you, but you priorities of the people of this borough.
Built on our climate change motion with an environmental plan
tree strategy and law, which is leading the way across the country as an exemplar of best practice. And I thank as well Councillor Gray for the work that she's done on that. And believe it or not, we are moving forward and replacing empty streetlights with the LED programme. We met the social care needs of over 20,000 people to ensure they supported every day kept safe. Used council reserve to provide necessary extra funding for social care, in spite of Tory government cuts, and thank Councillor Jones for that. So this party is moving forward, is doing things, and yet, as Councillor Kelly said, we're moving forward on council house building, but we're looking at all the options, and we can't do it overnight. There's three options, and we do want to do council house building, but there's no magic wand with it. But it's important, the only way we're going to do it is by all this council working together, particularly in the new committee system that you're bringing, and we're all for next year in municipality. So, thank you, Mr. Mayor, and thank you, everybody.
Okay, thank you, Councillor.
Thank you.
substantive motion, okay? As amended. Okay? Right, all. No, the substantive motion. The original substantive motion.
The original motion.
The original motion, okay. All those in favour.
Mr. Mayor, I wonder if we just help again. We are confusing the substantive motion on the main budget in your commentary, I think. You forgive me. We've had a vote which Lib Dem group went down massively.
Yes.
That was to remove one particular element of the capital monitoring report. The capital monitoring report contains other elements which I think we are happy to support, which I think all parties would. So if we have a vote on the rest of the capital monitoring, deal with that, I think that would be clarity. I'm happy to hear what the commission
would. Okay, that's what we're intending to do, the rest of the capital monitoring, okay? Okay, all those in favour, please.
Councillor
Cannon.
Councillor Carubia.
For.
Councillor Cottier.
For.
Councillor Cox.
Against.
Councillor George Davies.
For.
Councillor Bill Davies.
For.
Councillor Fowkes.
For.
Councillor Foss.
For.
Councillor Gardner.
Against.
Councillor Gilchrist.
For.
Councillor Carl Queenie.
For.
Councillor Jeff Green.
Against.
Councillor Gray.
For.
Councillor Hackett.
For.
Councillor Paul Hayes.
Against.
Councillor Stephen Hayes.
For.
Councillor Andrew Hodgson.
Against.
Councillor Cathy Hodgson.
Against.
Councillor Johnson.
Against.
Councillor Adrian Jones.
For.
Councillor Chris Jones.
For.
Councillor Sharon Jones.
For.
Councillor Tony Jones.
For.
Councillor Jordan.
Against.
Councillor Kelly.
For.
Councillor Kelly.
For.
Councillor Leach.
For.
Councillor Lewis.
Against.
Councillor McLaughlin.
For.
Councillor McManus.
For.
Councillor Mitchell.
For.
Councillor Muspratt.
For.
Councillor Nolan.
For.
Councillor Norbury.
For.
Councillor Bogle.
Against.
Councillor Lennon.
Against.
Councillor Robbins.
For.
Councillor Rowlands.
Against.
Councillor Smith.
Abstain.
Councillor Small.
For.
Councillor Spriggs.
For.
Councillor Stapleton.
For.
Councillor Stewart.
For.
Councillor Sullivan.
For.
Councillor Usher.
For.
Councillor Walsh.
For.
Councillor Watt.
Against.
Councillor Whittingham.
For.
Councillor Ivy Williams.
For.
Councillor Jerry Williams.
For.
Councillor Steve Williams.
Against.
Councillor Williamson.
For.
Councillor Wood.
For.
And Councillor Light.
Against.
Thank you, Madam.
The voting is votes in favour 43, votes against 21, abstentions 1. So that's been carried. Right, I'm just double checking here. The third vote, which was on the Liberal Democrat Group Amendment, that's been, so we're not going to vote on that. That's clear. Accepted. That's okay. You accept it. Right, move on to the fourth vote. The fourth vote will be in respect to the Conservative group objection. Okay? Everyone clear on that fourth vote? Okay? And this is short hand? Yeah, okay. Huh? All the same.
Thank you, members. Councillor Anders.
For.
Councillor Berry.
For.
Councillor Bird.
Against.
Councillor Bray.
Against.
Councillor Burgess Joyce.
For.
Councillor Cameron.
For.
Councillor Cannon.
Against.
Councillor Grubier.
Against.
Councillor Cleary.
Against.
Councillor Clemens.
For.
Councillor Collins.
For.
Councillor Cook.
Against.
Councillor Corkill.
Against.
Councillor Cottier.
Against.
Councillor Cox.
For.
Councillor George Davies.
Against.
Councillor Bill Davies.
Against.
Councillor Fowkes.
Against.
Councillor Foss.
Against.
Councillor Gardner.
For.
Councillor Gilchrist.
Against.
Councillor Carl Queenie.
Against.
Councillor Jeff Green.
For.
Councillor Gray.
Against.
Councillor Hackett.
Against.
Councillor Paul Hayes.
For.
Councillor Stephen Hayes.
Against.
Councillor Andrew Hodgson.
For.
Councillor Cathy Hodgson.
For.
Councillor Johnson.
For.
Councillor Adrian Jones.
Against.
Councillor Chris Jones.
Against.
Councillor Sharon Jones.
Against.
Councillor Tony Jones.
Against.
Councillor Jordan.
For.
Councillor Kelly.
Against.
Councillor Kenny.
Against.
Councillor Leach.
Against.
Councillor Lewis.
For.
Councillor McLaughlin.
Against.
Councillor McManus.
Against.
Councillor Mitchell.
Against.
Councillor Muspratt.
Against.
Councillor Nolan.
Against.
Councillor Norway.
Against.
Councillor Bogle.
For.
Councillor Rennie.
For.
Councillor Robinson.
Against.
Councillor Rowlands.
For.
Councillor Smith.
Abstaining.
Councillor Spall.
Against.
Councillor Spriggs.
Against.
Councillor Stapleton.
Against.
Councillor Stewart.
Against.
Councillor Jerry Williams.
Against.
Councillor Steve Williams.
For.
Councillor Williamson.
Against.
Councillor Wood.
Against.
And Councillor Light.
For.
Commands.
Okay, we've got votes in favour 21, votes against 43, abstentions 1, so that's been lost. Okay, right, we move on to the fifth vote, which is fifth vote will be on the Cabinet budget as amended by the Liberal Democrat Group Amendment. Yes?
Yes.
Clear on that? Okay. Right. Names again.
Councillor Anderson.
Against.
Councillor Berry.
Against.
Councillor Bird.
For.
Councillor Bray.
For.
Councillor Burgess Joyce.
Against.
Councillor Cameron.
For.
Against.
For.
Okay, the voting is as follows. Votes in favour 43, votes against 21, abstentions 1. So that's been carried. Right, the final vote this evening is the sixth vote, and this final vote is in respect to the statutory calculations in respect to the council tax precept as detailed on page 1 to 8 of the supplementary agenda. Okay, start again.
Councillor Anderson.
Again.
Councillor Berry.
Again.
Councillor Bird. Councillor Bray.
For.
Councillor Burgess Joyce.
Against.
Councillor Cameron.
Against.
Councillor Cameron.
For.
Councillor Gruby.
For.
Councillor Cleary.
For.
Councillor Clements.
Against.
Councillor Collins.
Against.
Councillor Cook.
For.
Councillor Cockhill.
For.
Councillor Cottier.
For.
Councillor Cox.
Against.
Councillor George Davis.
For.
Councillor Bill Davis.
For.
Councillor Farris.
For.
Councillor Foster.
For.
Councillor Gardner.
Against.
Councillor Gilchrist.
For.
Councillor Carl Queen.
For.
Councillor Jeff Queen.
Against.
Councillor Gray.
For.
Councillor Hackett.
For.
Councillor Paul Hayes.
Against.
Councillor Stephen Hayes.
For.
Councillor Andrew Hodson.
Against.
Councillor Cathy Hodson.
Against.
Councillor Johnson. Councillor Adrian Jones.
For.
Councillor Chris Jones.
For.
Councillor Sharon Jones.
For.
Councillor Tony Jones.
For.
Councillor Norbury.
For.
Councillor Bogle.
Against.
Councillor Rennie.
Against.
Councillor Robinson.
For.
Councillor Rowland.
Against.
Councillor Smith.
Abstaining.
Councillor Spall.
For.
Councillor Spriggs.
For.
Councillor Stapleton.
For.
Councillor Stewart.
For.
Councillor Sullivan.
For.
Councillor Usher.
For.
Councillor Walsh.
For.
Councillor Watt.
Against.
Councillor Whittingham.
For.
Councillor Hyman Williams.
For.
Councillor Jerry Williams.
For.
Councillor Steve Williams.
Against.
Councillor Williamson.
For.
Councillor Wood.
For.
And Councillor White.
Against.
Thank you, members.
Okay, the votes in favour, 43, the votes against, 21, abstentions, 1. So that's been carried. Can I just ask you, just before we finish, you probably saw in the papers and heard on you know, the emergency side about the incident that happened in Seacombe on Friday and that. And a lot of houses and Egremont Primary School had to be evacuated. And the children from Egremont Primary School came to the town hall here, and our staff did a wonderful job. So they invited me very quickly into Egremont this afternoon, and we've done 2 cards to say thank you to all the staff here, all the officers who played a part. And also, can I say that shops around the area supplied, you know, drinks and biscuits and things like that. So it was a really good community effort. So on behalf of everyone in the town hall, I'd just like, to, you know, for councillors to be